Nisharese, and I am back with another video. Today we're just gonna hop right into it per usual. Going to the fair today, so I wanted to get ready with you guys while I prepare for this outing. I am going to hop right into it using my Beauty Creations Elsa palette, and I'm going to start off. What am I starting off with? This brown kind of skin tone shade. So I'm just going to put that right on my brow bone, sweeping it back and forth. Y'all know the drill. And we're just gonna blend that all the way through. My sister, I've talked about her before, Candace Boyd, she's performing at the LA County Fair today. So we're all about to just go up there and eat, put some calories in our system, gain some weight, and then sweat it all off because it's so hot outside. And I'm going to use this burnt orange right here. And then watch her perform. So this should be fun. So I said, let me hop on camera and record since I'm already getting dressed. My eye, honestly, is probably an evening eye, but we extra. There's no rules to this. We can slay however, whenever, wherever. Do you feel me? So, this definitely could be a great nighttime look, but I'm gonna go ahead, since my outfit is kind of casual, I definitely want to serve looks with my eye. Yes. All right, I'm gonna hop into this burgundy shade right here. I actually love this palette. I got it from a kiosk at my mall. And the colors are very pigmented, and I do use it a lot, believe it or not, even though I'm always showcasing Juvia's place, but I like this palette too. So I'm just putting this burgundy color in my crease, and then we're just blending that slightly upwards. Went out last night, so I can't even believe I'm halfway alive right now. Your girl is low-key working with a headache, aka hangover. Don't tell nobody. But I'm taking a e.l.f. blending brush, and this one doesn't have any product on, so I'm just making sure there's no harsh lines in between all of those colors that I just laid down. Same routine. We gonna get this together, y'all. Beginner friendly. Cause I for sure ain't no pro. Hey, your girl got bars. Did y'all hear that? I for sure ain't no pro. Okay, so now that we have that laid down, you know what? I'm gonna deepen it just a little bit. I'm gonna go in with this black shade. I forgot I did that on the other eye. Going with this black shade and deepen up just that outer corner and that crease just a little bit. Now, if it was a nighttime event, I might smoke this out even more and just adding and packing on that black shade. But since this is a daytime fair, I'm not gonna step on their necks too hard. But it's still gonna be a slay. So I just wanna keep blending because that black is kind of harsh. But once it marries together with the burgundies and the orange and the browns, it looks pretty, pretty good. Okay. So I'm gonna go back in same e.l.f. brush, and I'm gonna get that pick up that burgundy color. This palette is big, so it's kind of hard for me to show the colors like I need to. But I'm putting that burgundy right on top of that black so that it can be a little easier for me to blend out. Y'all see that? Y'all see that? It is hot. I can't even imagine what this fair is about to be like. Okay. So we have that. Let me tap those colors in just a little bit. All right, so we're gonna go in with Old Faithful Faithful, the NYX Glitter Primer. I'm taking just a small angled brush. Y'all know the drill. I'm just laying that over my entire lid. I put a generous amount on so that I can look down. I feel so crazy every time I do that. Like, what is she doing? All I'm doing, and I've said this before, but it's okay, we're gonna say it again. I'm trying to find where my crease is so that I can place the shadow above my crease so that you can see the colors like this when my eyes are open. If you put it too far down, you can only see your colors when you're looking down, and ain't nobody walking around looking down. We looking up, sis. So that's all. All I'm doing, this gives the illusion of a cut crease. Honestly, I probably won't even do a cut crease, even though I said I would, but I probably won't do one ever again, even though I never say never, because I might. But this is just so much easier and faster, and it gives the same end result. You feel me? Can y'all see? I feel like I'm blocking the lens. I'm just trying to straighten up that line, make it as precise as possible. All right, so now that we have that down, we want it to get a little tacky. I'm gonna take just a flat, kind of a packing brush. I'm spraying it with Old Faithful Faithful. And then I'm going to go in with my new Makeup Revolution palette. I love this one. These colors are so, look at that. Bomb. Bomb. I can't wait to slay. But I'm gonna take this goldish, yellowish color right there. And I'm just going to lay that, pack that down onto my lid. It's pretty pigmented. Pretty pigmented. Why can't I say the word? Pigmented. So I'm just following what I laid down. Of course, I'm leaving my tear ducts or my inner corners open so that I can lay another color down per usual. But I'm just following that line, trying not to go over that line. If you do, it's okay, it's an easy way to clean it up. But just pack that color onto the lid. This color would go with so many, like this turquoise blue in this palette, this pink. So many colors are calling my name. But my outfit is just basically black and brown, leopard. So I'm trying to be low key. Okay, so we are going to, I'm gonna go back into that Beauty Creations palette, and I'm gonna take that black shade first with a black, packing brush, and I'm gonna tap that onto my outer corners and kind of meeting it up, bringing it up to my crease. See that? And then I'm gonna take, what am I taking? I'm gonna go in with a smaller packing brush, and I'm gonna go into that burgundy color and lay that on top of the gold, also overlapping the black. Just putting those colors together. And then I like to kind of turn the brush sideways and just kind of flicker it so that it doesn't have, so that the lines kind of blend seamlessly into the other lines. We don't want it to be so harsh. And then I'll take that empty packing blending brush and just kind of tap over, get in that crease, blend that out just a little bit. Just a little bit. And that black is a little patchy. So I'm gonna spray the brush. Let's see if that picks up better. If not, I'll lay the glitter primer down. But this should. This should work, should do the trick. Yeah, we got it. We got it. You got it, girl. You got it. Okay. So I'm going to go in with the normal whitish gold color that I like in my tear ducts, the Juvia's Place. I'm just laying a little bit more down so that color can stick. And then the whitish, goldish color that I like to use is, of course, in my favorite palette. It's the Masquerade Mini Palette, Juvia's Place. And I'm just going into this whitish gold color. I think it's called Giza. Giza, Giza. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but that's what I think it says. And I'm just packing or pressing that color. And then I'm following that line a little bit just to make it pop. The line that was laid down by the NYX primer. Super easy, guys. Baby, this is a slay. And that, my friend, is the eyes. All right, so this brings us to the end of the video. Hopefully you like, you enjoy, you picked up a tip or a trick or something that you can use when you slay your face. I would say, this is cute. She cute, cute. We gonna be at the fair. Slaying today. Anyways, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. Follow my Instagram, Nisharese and COA Certified. Check out my website if you want to go shopping, pick up something, a thing or two for yourself, for your girl, for your friend, auntie, uncle, whoever. The website is COACertified.com. And per usual, I, Nisharese, will see you in my next video. Bye.